गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल सी चैप्टर वन, न्यूट्रिशन इन प्लांट्स। सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस चैप्टर विल सी डिफरेंट डिफरेंट मोड्स ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन। सो वी ऑल नो दैट फूड इज द बेसिक एंड इम्पॉर्टेंट नीड फॉर द लिविंग बींग्स। द वेरियस कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ फूड्स लाइक कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स, प्रोटीन्स, फैट्स, वाइटमिन्स एंड मिनरल्स कलेक्टिवली कॉल्ड न्यूट्रिएंट्स। ओके, that means all plants and animals require food for their growth, and that means getting energy. That means we need food for our growth and for the energy. The process of utilizing the food to obtain energy, that means what is the process? It is the process of utilizing, that means food to obtain energy for the growth and development is called nutrition. Plants make their food themselves. We all know that plant make their food themselves, but animals cannot. We cannot make their own food. Hence, animals depend directly or indirectly on plants. In this chapter, we'll see that means mode of nutrition. So, two types of mode we'll see. First one is autotrophic nutrition, second one is heterotrophic nutrition. So, one by one, we'll discuss. Autotrophic nutrition, that means it is the mode of nutrition in which an organism makes its food itself from simple or inorganic substances is called autotrophic nutrition. That means organism make its food itself. Green plants make their food from carbon dioxide and water in the presence of chlorophyll and sunlight. So the mode of nutrition in green plants is autotrophic nutrition. Some green plants produce food for themselves as well as for animals and human beings. Then the organism which make their food own from the simple substances present in the environment are called autotrophs. Autotrophs are the producer of food. Autotrophs are producer of food, so they are called producers. Heterotrophic, second one is heterotrophic nutrition. The mode of nutrition in which organism which cannot make their food and depend on others for getting the food is called heterotrophic nutrition. Such organism are called heterotrophs. It is the mode of nutrition, heterotrophic means it is the mode of nutrition in which cannot make their food, in which organism cannot make their food itself and depend on the others for getting the food is called heterotrophic nutrition. Such organism are heterotrophs. Then animals and humans do not make their food. They eat the food prepared by the plants or eat the flesh of the smaller animals. Therefore all animals, humans are heterotrophs. Heterotrophs consume the food made by producers, so they are called consumers. So we are consumers. We cannot make their own food, so we are consumers. Then students, after that we'll understand the photosynthesis process. Photosynthesis, that means food making process in plants. So photosynthesis, what? Photosynthesis is the process by which green plants make their own food. Okay, is known as what? Photosynthesis. Photo means light and synthesis means building up. The process of photosynthesis is carried out in leaves. Photosynthesis starts in leaves. The leaves are green due to the presence of a pigment called chlorophyll. Chlorophyll helps to capture the energy of the sun. Green plants use carbon dioxide present in the air and water present in the soil to make food in the presence of chlorophyll and sunlight. The whole process can be described here, that means as equation it is given, carbon dioxide plus water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, carbohydrate, food stored in the plant, carbohydrate plus oxygen is released by the plant. Okay, at the last see here, oxygen is released and here it is given carbon dioxide plus water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, carbohydrate plus oxygen. That means product is carbohydrate plus oxygen. Then here green plants during photosynthesis take in carbon dioxide through stomata in their leaves. Stomata is what? Stomata is the tiny pores present in the surface of leaves. These are surrounded by the bean-shaped guard cell. Exchange of gases takes place through the stomata. Thus, carbon dioxide enters the leaf through these pores. That means carbon dioxide enters in the plant through the stomata. Water and minerals are absorbed through the network of vessels which form hair-like pipelines from the root. These pipelines are present throughout the plant from root to the branches and leaves. Chlorophyll, the green pigment in leaves, absorbs sunlight. That means green pigments of the leaves absorb sunlight. Carbon dioxide and water converts them into carbohydrate and oxygen. Oxygen is released into the atmosphere, and carbohydrate that ultimately converts into starch is stored as food. That means carbohydrate stored as starch, and it is stored as food. Starch is stored as food. The food is transported to the other parts of the plant.